Hi. In certain situations, the mother may be forced to stop her breastfeeding. Today, we are going to see about that. Lactation suppression means it's the act of suppressing lactation by medication or by other non-pharmacological methods. That is, by using the medications or by using any other method, forcefully, we are stopping the breastfeeding. That is the suppression of lactation. Now we are going to see the situations where the mother is forced to or the mother will be forced to stop the breastfeeding. First one is inconvenience of the mother. For example, if the mother is forced to go to a different location for her job or for some other activity, that is a reason. Or sometimes in US and UK, majority or 20% of the ladies, they don't want to breastfeed the baby. That also may be a reason. Otherwise, if the breastfeeding is risky for the newborn, for example, if the mother is having HIV and if you are suspecting the transmission of HIV to the mother, HIV to the baby, in those conditions also, you can stop the breastfeeding. Other include if the mother is having severe or moderate breast engorgement, or if she is having severe pain, or if the mother is having mastitis, that is infection of the breast, in the case of death of the baby, and if the mother is having serious psychiatric disorders, in these conditions, we may not be able to continue the breastfeeding. So in that case, we may go for the suppression of lactation. Now we can see the methods that we can use for suppressing the lactation. We can use the pharmacological methods and non-pharmacological methods. The non-pharmacological methods include breast binding, strapping of the breast, emptying the breast, that is by using breast pump or manually you can empty the breast, restricting the fluid intake, and application of external products. Example, application of belladonna ointment, application of cabbage leaves, ice packs, jasmine flower. These things are applying in local areas and it is found that these things are good or these things are beneficial to a certain extent. Next is pharmacological methods. We can use estrogen therapy or you can use estrogen in combination with progesterone. This may suppress the lactation or this may suppress the breastfeeding. Otherwise, you can use the dopaminergic drugs, example bromocriptine, or otherwise we can use anti-serotonergic drugs, example ciproheptadine. Otherwise, we can start clomiphene, pyridoxine, prostaglandin E2 or furosemide. By using this pharmacological or non-pharmacological methods, we can stop or we can reduce the production of breast milk. By that way, we can reduce the inconvenience and discomfort of the mother due to the production of breast milk. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon with the next video.